today the topic of our discussion is the germination of seeds. Now, what is germination? Germination is the formation of a new plant from the embryo. That means the seed becomes active. The seeds what we have in our at our homes also, in our cans, in our containers, they are inactive seeds. So when you soak in water, they swell up and then the embryo inside the seeds becomes active and it forms a new root and the stem part. Now we say that this germination, it is a process of formation of a new plant from the inactive embryo. So as the embryo becomes, now how this germination takes place? It is when the seeds are soaked in water. That means when you place the seeds in the soil and it is well watered, the seeds will absorb water from the soil with the help of process called as imbibation. Imbibation is a process by which the seeds are absorbing water from the soil because they have cellulose on them, on the cell wall. So this cellulose is absorbing water from the soil. So as they absorb water, water will swell up, it will be present in the seeds. The seeds will swell up, the seed coat will become soft by the presence of water and it will rupture. As it will rupture, the embryo will become active and the food which is stored in the cotyledons in the solid form, it will be converted, the enzymes will be released and it will be converted into a simple diffusible form and that will be given to the embryo. The embryo is having the plumule and the radicle. The plumule is forming the stem part of the plant and the radicle is forming the root part of the plant. Now, the types of germination. Let's see the types of germination. Now, the types of germination are two. The germination is of two kinds, epigeal and hypogeal. Epigeal germination is the cotyledons are remaining, they come out of soil and they form the leaves of the plant that is found in the bean plant. But the hypogeal germination is the cotyledons of the seed, they remain inside the soil only and the leaves are formed by the plumule part of the embryo that is present in the maize plant. Let's see the diagram. In epigeal germination, see this diagram. This is the seed present in the soil. It will absorb water from the soil and the embryo will become active and it will form the radicle. The radicle will first come out. Radicle will form the root. It will grow and it is now this radicle is, the growth of radicle is there, but it is more than the plumule part and the plumule is forming the leaves. The leaves are formed over here and the cotyledons are coming out of this. Yes, these are the cotyledons and this is the leaves which are being formed from the cotyledons. So this is the root part formed. This is the primary root, the secondary roots and the tertiary roots are formed. These are the leaf-like structures, are the cotyledons. They are coming out of the soil and then the leaves appear. So this kind of germination in the bean seed is called as epigeal germination. Now we come to hypogeal germination. Now in this hypogeal germination, as in the maize grain, because it is a grain, there is a covering of the plumule and the radicle because it is a single cotyledon. So the covering of plumule is called as coleotile and the covering of radicle is called as coleorhiza. Coleotile is the covering of the plumule, the protective covering of plumule, and coleorhiza is protective covering of the radicle, the root part. This is the stem. So the stem plumule is forming first, there is more growth of that and the cotyledons are remaining in the soil only. The cotyledons are in the soil and the leaves are coming out. So the first leaves are arising from the plumule part only, because this is found in the maize grain, that is a monocot. So the epigeal germination is found in dicots, whereas the hypogeal germination is found in monocots. Now we come to the processes which help, the factors which help in germination. Now we come to the conditions which are required for germination. The very first condition which is required for germination is water. Water is very important because as the seeds will absorb water, they will swell up. So this water which is absorbed by the seeds, that will soften the seed coat, and as it will soften the seed coat, it will be responsible for the growth of embryo, because it will activate the embryo because it is inactive first. And second, a very important part is that the food which is present in the cotyledons, that is present in the complex forms, the water will be converting, it will be helped to convert the complex forms of food to simpler forms of food, and the embryo will become active, it will secrete enzymes and the water will convert the food into simple diffusible forms and it will be given to the embryo and it will form the new leaves and the new root part of it. Yes, then we talk about is oxygen. Oxygen is very important for the growth of embryo. Why? Because the oxygen because the energy is required for growth and the formation of new cells. Now this energy which is required, we say that this is given by respiration. So for respiration, the breakdown of food, oxygen is required. Third is the temperature. Temperature is very important because the seeds which are given out in very high and very low temperature, that is in winters and in summers, some seeds require in summers they require the temperature 25 to 35 degrees centigrade, and in winter some seeds require 10 to 20 degrees centigrade. Yes, but the right temperature is very important. That is the optimum temperature in which the enzymes becomes active and they are converting the complex forms of food to simpler forms of food. Let's see the diagram for this. Now the from this experiment the conditions will be more clear. We have three seeds of the same type, that is A, B and C. On the same slide we have typed these seeds. A is at the top, C is at the bottom and B is in the center. We have taken a beaker full of water, half filled of water. The level of water is same as the level of the B seed, the second seed. Now A is getting oxygen from the air and the right temperature, but it is not getting water. So no water, no conversion of food into simpler forms, and the embryo will not become active. C, slight germination will be there. Yes, why? Because it is getting the oxygen which is dissolved in water, it is getting the right temperature, it is getting water also. So some growth will be there, but as the oxygen which is dissolved in water will be used up by the seed, the germination will stop. But this B, which is in the second, in the middle of the slide, this will have maximum germination, we can see in this diagram. Why? Because it is getting oxygen from the air, it is getting oxygen from the water also. It is getting the right temperature, it is getting the water. So all the three conditions are being provided to the seed. So the embryo becomes most active in this and the maximum germination takes place. Thank you so much.